booth. Still I get them repentance bars buzzing on the proof. Far I'm up, get the news. Stay ahead of your ending. I'll pen a pen, penicillin, send it in. Still the villain, stick a note in your throat. I'm ill with the quotes, so stick on them pads like lymph nodes. Sending out sick notes. You don't really want the smoke when you choke. I am what you not. Hang you with your own rope. Put these lines under you, spell a hangman. Shake them then quick and I bake them then take them and rank them. I'm making a statement, placing my stake in the face of a hater. I stick them fillet them, but I don't cater with my kidneys. Motherfucker, you basic. If you hate it, then say it. I don't really break from the bacon. Or you want beef, I get it catered for you.
Whoever sees this and subscribes right now will get a free bag of M&M's. You know who we got up today. What's going on, YouTube? It's Knox Hill, and we're back with our reaction series. So today, be careful what you wish for. We had Game come out and talk about the battle between Eminem and MGK. And we're now going past the anniversary of that since Rap Devil came out, since Killshot came out. And you guys have been commenting, you've been requesting that I break these tracks down. But just a quick note before we go any further, guys, I want to give a quick shout out to my Patreon who also requested this. We are now doing Patreon only reactions and content on there and building that community. It is lit. So if you like the content, you like what I'm doing, then check out that link. It will be below. But anyways, Eminem, MGK, a lot of debate on who won this. A lot of debate on who walked away with the W. So we're going to break it down. We are going to deep dive into these, and this is going to be a long video. I'm warning you now, but I'm going to stack both of them up. We're going to do both of them in one video. So let's go. World star. Let's go. Hey, Coulson. What are you going to do when you get up in the morning?
Well, I'm going to walk outside of my tour bus without a shirt on and look badass eating a bowl of cereal. So I start my day eating rappers alive.
No, I mean, you got to like the swagger, though. You got to like the swagger, right? And if you notice the color grading, it kind of reminds me of an NF style where, you know, you take some of the colors and there's like a super desaturation to it. It gives it a very cinematic look, and it's dark, it's gritty, it sets the tone already. And here he is with the shovel, obviously mimicking Eminem in his famous song Cleaning Out My Closet when he had a shovel. Let's go.
Oh my god, Ronnie.
Hey, somebody grab him some clippers. His fucking beard is weird. Tough talk from a rapper paying millions for security a year. I think my dad
his fucking beard's weird. I mean, Eminem obviously responded to this and handled it because if you're going to come out swinging on your first line, I just feel like, you got a weird beard. That's the best that you got. But then he followed it up with, you know, tough talk for a rapper paying millions in security a year. Like, I like that one. I like that one. Poking fun at him. Like, you need all this security, all these bodyguards because you can't handle your own business. That's nice. That's a nice line.
Gone crazy. Tough talk from a rapper paying millions for security a year. My dad's gone crazy. Yeah, Haley, you right. Dad's always mad, cooped up in the studio, yelling at the mic. You sober and bored.
I think my dad's gone crazy. That was where he put Haley in it. She was on the hook. That was on the Eminem show, that song. So I like how he took something from M's discography and he flipped it on him, right? That's clever. He does this a couple times throughout this where he takes, you know, some classic M songs and M references and he turns them on their head. That's some nice tactics for a diss track. And then you hear like the girl voice in the background that sounds like it could be Haley. And all of this started because of his tweet about Haley when she was 16 and he was what, 21, 22? And he said that she was hot and has pissed off Eminem. So this is where it originated. So obviously he's going to bring up Haley into it. And again, it's a diss track, man. I mean, there are no limits in diss battles, but as a family man myself, you start talking about my daughter and my family, I'm coming for you.
You right. Dad's always mad, cooped up in the studio, yelling at the mic. You sober and bored.
Again, he has these great punchlines, and then he's got these other lines that just, they do kind of miss for me, but I mean, if you're going to miss, at least deliver with swagger. And he's got so much swagger, and there's just like this, you know, this other value that he adds to it with, you know, how he carries himself, how he handles his delivery. Like, you're making fun of someone for yelling at the mic, literally for, like, doing their job, for recording, for yelling at the mic. Like, I don't know. It's a little weak for me.
You right.
dad's always mad, cooped up in the studio yelling at the mic. You sober and bored, huh?
I know.
About to be 46 years old, dog. Talking about, I'ma call up Trick Trick. Man, you sound like a bitch, bitch. Man, I can handle your shit. You mad about something?
I like that flip, again, because in Not Alike, M follows up his disses, his subliminal, you know, bars about Machine Gun Kelly, and he says he's going to call up Trick Trick, the rapper from Detroit, okay? And MGK is taking that and going, oh, I'm going to call up Trick Trick. Like, handle your own shit like a man. I do like that. I like some of these punches, man. He's swinging. Listen, if you're going to go for a king and a goat, you got to swing, man.
I'm going to call up Trick Trick. Man, you sound like a bitch, bitch. Man, I can handle your shit. Mad about something I said in 2012. Took you 6 years and a surprise album just to come with a diss. Homie, we get it. We know that you're the greatest rapper alive.
I tell you what, I'm going to switch. I don't know what is wrong with my internet today, but that is not coming through very clearly. So I'm just going to switch my phone hotspot. Let's go. Hopefully that helps, man, because that's just going to... Come on, we need to see this clearly. We need to break it down.
Fucking dweeb, all you do is read the dictionary and stay inside. Fuck rap god, I'm the rap devil. Come a bare face with a black shovel like the...
Oh, man, okay. So now he's making fun of M. So, you know, he knows that he's going against someone who's lyrically superior. So what do? You got to discredit that in some way. So this is clever, too. Like, he's saying, you know, all you do is read the fucking dictionary. That's all you do. You're not out living life. Like, I'm making music about real life and real life events. Like, you're so wealthy now, you don't even go out anymore. You just sit there and make music all day, but it's not the same. It doesn't have the same struggle and the same passion that I have. You've forgotten that because all you do is worry about flipping these words and sounding cool with it.
Read the dictionary and stay inside. Fuck rap god, I'm the rap devil. I'm a bare face with a black shovel like the Armageddon. When the smoke settle, his body next to this instrumental. I'm saying, I'm sick.
And then obviously Eminem, Rap God, another famous M song that he's taken, and he's flipping, I'm the rap devil, and I love how he makes the devil horns with it. And listen, the title of this track, Rap Devil, like, you know, use the title, take that as an opportunity to diss the person you're going after as well. So he's dissing Rap God at the same time he's hyping himself up, because he's the devil on this.
Sweatsuits and them corny hats, let's talk.
I'm sick of them sweatsuits and them corny hats, huh?
Settle, his body next to this instrumental, I'm saying. I'm sick of them sweatsuits and them corny hats, let's talk about it. I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad, let's talk about it. Both of us single dads from the Midwest, we can talk about it. Or we can get gully, I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it.
I mean, he does put autotune on that. I think Eminem takes advantage of that, too. It's not a bad hook, to be honest, but I'm a little old school with my diss tracks, okay? And again, we're giving constructive criticism here. I do like this diss track from MGK, and I'll get more into it later, but I'm also just picking out certain points and certain flaws that I see, and, you know, it's a diss track, all right? Old school, you don't put hooks. You don't have, like, catchy hooks that you want to get people to sing along to. It's a diss, man. We're not putting hooks on here. You just keep swinging. You come bar after bar after bar and give it your best shot. That's what you do. Don't put like a song structure over a diss track. Come on.
Let's talk about the fact you actually blackballed a rapper that's twice as young as you. Let's call Sway, ask why I can't go up to Shape 45 because of you.
No.
Let's ask Interscope how you had Paul Rosenberg trying to shelf me. Still can't cover up the fact your last 4 hours as bad as your selfie. Now tell me, what are you paying for?
Now we got a little bit of digging here. We got a little bit of facts that he's throwing around, at least from his side in the way that he sees it. Like he's saying, like, Eminem is twice as old as me, and he tried to blackball me. He tried to blackball me with the label, with Interscope, because MGK is signed to Interscope, M's label, but also he signed to Bad Boy. So, you know, M's manager is Paul Rosenberg. He's saying, you know, you called up Paul trying to handle me. You called up Interscope trying to handle me, trying to blackball me. I can't even go on Shade 45, your radio station anymore, and do Sway in the Morning or any of Sway's stuff because you won't let me.
I know you can't stand yourself, bro. Trying to be the old you so bad you stand yourself.
Ah, that's the best line of this whole thing. Hang on. Bring this back. We got to appreciate it.
Still can't cover up the fact your last 4 hours as bad as your selfie. Now tell me, what do you stand?
That's key too. Your last 4 albums. 4 albums. Remember that. He's saying your last 4 albums are as bad as your selfie. So he's making some age jokes here.
I know you can't stand yourself, bro. Trying to be the old you so bad you stand yourself. Let's leave all the beef in the fit.
I love that. Because, you know, now Eminem's fans, like serious fans, are called stans. Eminem had that infamous song, Stan, where Stan became obsessed with M. M never responded to him or any of his letters. And then he sees him in the news later on, and there's this big flip on it. But he's saying, like, you know, Stan wanted to be like M, and Stans want to be like you. You want to be the OU so bad. You're standing yourself. That's an amazing flip, man. That's a great diss right there. I heard that and I was like, oh, okay. Boy swinging now.
Please, M, you're pushing 50. Why you claiming I'ma call Puff when you the one that called Diddy?
Facts.
Then you went and called Jimmy.
Facts.
The conference called me in the morning. They told me.
You called Diddy. You called Jimmy Iovine. You're saying I called him? No. I didn't call Diddy a bad boy. All right. I didn't call my boss. You called my boss and you got your boss on the line with him trying to say about, well, let's let it keep going because I'm jumping ahead of myself now.
You the one that called Diddy.
Facts.
Then you went and called Jimmy.
Facts.
The conference called me in the morning. They told me you mad about a tweet. You wanted me to say sorry. I swear to God, I ain't believe him. Please say it ain't so. The big bad bully of the rap game can't take a fucking joke. Oh, you want some fucking smoke?
I like that. He's painting him out to be a bully, right? He's dragging him through the mud now, saying, again, there's this constant theme of you can't handle your own business. You pay for a bodyguard. You don't want to handle things yourself anymore. You just stay cooped up inside, just making your music. You're not out here living this life that I'm living. I'm out here struggling. I'm trying to put food on my daughter's table. Right? You see this? You see how he's painting? It's very clever, man. You know what it's like? It's like MGK just makes me think of like this very blue collar, like get down to work, gritty type of flow, going up against like the rich, the white collar dude. And he's going against that because he's got the heart, man, and he's swinging. You know, there's a lot of relatability to this. And there's a lot of swagger to it, man. I definitely like that. Points for MGK on that.
The big bad bully of the rap game can't take a fucking joke. Oh, you want some fucking smoke, but not literally, you'll choke. Yeah, I'll acknowledge.
Can't take a fucking joke. Oh, you want some smoke? Not literally, you'll choke. Joke, smoke, choke. I'm going to point this out when M comes through. But if you listen to a lot of MGK's rhyme schemes, it's not like there's a lot of internal rhymes. He's just focusing on the end rhymes. Yeah, he's saying some punchlines. He's got some hard-hitting bars. But, you know, one thing we'll look at later on is the technicals, right? And if you stack M's technicals up to MGK's, they don't really compare. But MGK can do that. Like, he's keeping a lot of the same flow. He's staying a lot in the same pocket. When Eminem comes through on Killshot, he's got a lot of flow switches, a lot of changes in his delivery and what he's doing. And technically, is definitely superior if you want to break it down from that perspective.
The goat, but I'm the gunner, bitch. I got you in the scope. Don't have a heart attack now. Somebody help your man's up.
Help.
Knees weak or old age. The real Slim Shady can't stand up.
Nah.
Sick of them sweatsuits.
Another nice flip on Eminem, you know, with a real Slim Shady, please stand up. So he's taking that. You can't stand up because you're getting old. You got bad knees now, M. I mean, yeah, it's let's make fun of him for being old. So that's kind of weak to me. But what I do like, again, is when he's taking like famous sayings from M and famous songs and flipping them in that way.
Corny ass, let's talk about it.
Oh, back to this hook again.
Being rich and you still mad, let's talk about it. Up of a single dad's from the Midwest,
we can talk about it.
Or we can get gully, you'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it. Hello, Marshall. My name's Colson.
Oh, a little slang for you guys. We can get gully. Like, we can get violent. You know, we can start banging in here if you want to bang. And he's making fun of him for the sweatsuits. But that, you know, especially in the 90s, man, that was a typical hip-hop look right there. So he's making fun of M for, what, his fashion, I guess? Because when you just wear nothing but a scarf, that is, that's fashion. I just called it a scarf. You know, it's a bandana.
You should go back to recovery. I know your ego is hurting just knowing that all of your fans discovered me. He like, damn, he a...
That was important. Let's bring it back real quick.
To recovery. Up your body and put some white chalk around it. Hello, Marshall. My name's Colson. You should go back to recovery. I know your ego is hurting.
Hi, Marshall. I'm Colson. How are you? How are you doing today? I do like that swagger. That's a little bit of humor to it, too. But he's saying, you should go back to recovery. Like, you should go back to that album. That was a better you than what you're putting out now and what you're doing. And here's the problem. In the second verse, he said, you know, your last four albums have sucked. They're as bad as your selfie. Well, recovery is within those last four albums. Recovery's three albums ago. So now he's saying that those albums suck, but you should go back to one of those albums that sucked. See, M takes that. You can't give M any openings. You give him a little bit, man, and he'll turn that screw in. Like, you need to be a little bit more polished. I don't know why he didn't review that and compare that to his second verse. I mean, it's not like he rushed this out. He had time to get it together and get it ready.
Just knowing that all of your fans discovered me.
Hi. Damn, he a younger me. Except he dresses better and I'm ugly. Always making fun of me. Stop all the thuggery, Marshall. You living in luxury. Hey, look what you've done to me. Dropped an album just because of me. Damn, you in love with me. You got money, but I'm...
I do like that. Again, simple, basic disses, some of them, you know, make fun of his age, make fun of his looks, but there is some cleverness mixed throughout, and that's what I'm going to point out, because those are the bars that I like, you know what I mean? Those are the ones that I feel, and, you know, talking about, you dropped a whole album just because of me, like, you're so worried about me that you had to come out with Kamikaze, which was basically just a big diss album, and you had to talk about me on that, because you're just obsessed with me. I do like that. He's trolling them. He's trolling them a little bit. That's some clever bars.
I like a diss, but you won't say them lyrics out in front of me. Shout out to every rapper that's a fun to me. Know that I'll never do you like this fuckery. Still bitter after everyone loves you. Pull that wedgie out your dungarees. I gotta respect the OGs, and I know most of them personally. Hey, but you just a bully acting like a baby, so I gotta read you a nursery. I'm the ghost of the future, and you just Ebenezer Scrooge.
You just acting like a baby, I gotta read you a nursery. I mean, again, simplified, but then we have simple lines, and then I love this one. This is more well thought out. You know, he's the ghost of the future, and you're Ebenezer Scrooge. So he is showing you your downfall and what you're going to become. You know, you carry on this path, this is a preview of what's going to happen. So he's relaying it to a Christmas girl here. That was clever. That was well thought through.
Said I'm flex, anyone can get it. I'm the ghost of the future, and you just Ebenezer Scrooge. I said I'm flex, anyone can get it. I know it will be you.
Nah.
I'm sick of them sweatsuits.
He went on Flex, you know, Funk Flex. He dropped his freestyle, right? And he basically just put out a warning. It's all rappers, man. You guys want the smoke out? You can come get it. You can come get it. So I like that line too. That's him swagging now. Like, I didn't know that you would be the one I gotta come get.
Corny ass, let's talk about it. I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad, let's talk about it. All of us single dads from the Midwest, we can talk about it. Or we can get gully, I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it. Hey, ride a shoddy, cause I got a road, it's dope. It's a fast road. When your idols become your rivals, yeah.
I like that line, when your idols become your rivals, because he did look up to M and he was influenced by M. So it's kind of crazy that now he's in this situation where he's going after someone that he listened to and that he was a fan of. You know, that's got to be a tough situation to be put in and to do. So you have to appreciate that perspective. And again, we're commenting on this because I don't know why this annoys me, but he's got a bridge. This is a bridge now. Like, it's kind of sing-songy. He's doing this bridge to carry out the song with, but this is a diss track. Like, use a bridge in an actual song, not in a diss track. Just drop your bars, be mean, be nasty, swing and walk away. But, you know, some people might like this. I get that, but I'm old school. I'm old school with my disses, guys.
Never hesitate to say it to your face. I'm an asshole.
Bitch ass motherfucker.
We know you get nervous, rabbit. I see mama spaghetti all over your sweater. I wish you would lose yourself in the records that you made a decade ago. They were better recorded.
It's a good line again. You know, there's vomit on his sweater already. Mom spaghetti. So he's saying, you know, you're throwing up on yourself now. You lost yourself in those records years ago. They were so much better than you who was here now. Like, you're not the same. You're not the same. And that was a popular criticism of M. And honestly, I was kind of on that train too. But then Kamikaze dropped. I like Kamikaze. And then, man, Music to be Murdered by. If we got anything out of this, I think MGK helps to light a new fire under Eminem and just remotivate and refocus this man. But again, nice play on his discography. Clever lines.
To them, you're a national treasure. To me, you're as soft as a feather. The type to be scared to ask Rihanna for a number. Just hold her umbrella, Ella, Ella. I'm not afraid. Okay.
I'm not afraid. Making fun of M's song, Not Afraid. I like that. And then obviously Rihanna's song, Umbrella, saying that M is scared to ask her for a number. That's straightforward.
Rihanna for a number, just hold her umbrella, Ella, Ella. I'm not afraid. Okay, Oscar the Grouch, chill on the couch. Fuck. You got an Oscar, damn. Can anyone else get some food in their mouth? For real. They made a movie about you. You and everybody's top 10. You're not getting better with time. It's fine, Eminem, put down the pen. Or write in the...
I like how he did that. Eminem put down the pen and he just threw his spoon down. He's got some nice, you know, camera presence. And just, again, like I said, some of these bars don't necessarily hit as hard, but because of how he delivers it, the tone of his voice, the pauses, and then the video itself, it just lends itself so well to being a diss track and just making it feel like, oh, I should go over there. Like, oh, okay.
apology. Or with a simple fact, you had a diss to acknowledge me. I am the prodigy. How could I even look up to you? You ain't as tall as me. 5'8", man, I'm 6'4". 7 punches, hold your head still. Last time you saw 8 Mile was at home on a treadmill. You were named after a candy.
So you saw 8 Mile, you're home, because Eminem is from 8 Mile, the movie 8 Mile, right, in Detroit. But you're only seeing 8 miles because you're running on a treadmill. That's all you're doing because you're indoors, again, playing off of that. And then he's saying, how can I look up to you? You know, you say you're the rap god, but I can't look up to you because I'm actually taller than you. You know, if you want to throw down, you want to take this to fists, I will handle you. Again, a very, very blue-collar flow and style, man. He's grinding. He's just saying, like, you want to get in the ring with me? You want to swing? Let's go.
I was named after a gangster, and don't be at home on a treadmill. You were named after a candy. I was named after a gangster.
Is he eating M&M's? Because he spit out the cereal, but if that is delicious cereal that looked like Lucky Charms, do not spit out Lucky Charms, man. Those marshmallows are too good to spit out. Come on. And obviously he's got the lines, you know, you're named after a candy, M&M. I'm named after a gangster, you know. The old days, the crime bosses, the gangsters, Machine Gun Kelly.
Don't be a sucker and take my verse off of Yellow Wolf's album. Thank you. Thank you. I just want to feel.
I don't think he took that verse off Yellow Wolf's album, did he? Somebody comment below if he did or not. I don't think so. Because, again, he responds to this later on. He would never take someone's food out of someone's daughter's mouth.
After a gangster, and don't be a sucker and take my verse off of Yellow Wolf's album. Thank you. Thank you. I just want to feed my daughter. You try to stop the money to support her. You the one always talk about the action. Text me to Addy. I'm pulling up scrapping. And I'm by my fucking self. What's happening? EST cap to salute me and shoot me. That's what he's going to have to do to me when he realizes.
This is a nice flow. This, I haven't talked much about his flow because there hasn't been a ton of flow switches. He stayed in the same pocket, but towards the end here, he starts to speed it up, and he's letting the end lines now fall right in the middle of the beat, which is nice, and he's just coming swinging, man. He's not saying, like, crazy wordplay or bars. He's just keeping it real, man. Like, text me your address. I'll be there on my own. I don't need bodyguards. I don't need all these people watching me.
That ain't shit he can do to me. Everybody always hated me. This isn't anything new to me.
Nice.
Yeah, there's a difference between us. I got all of my shit without Dre producing me. Aye. I know you're not used to me. Usually one of your disses should ruin me. But bitch, I'm from Cleveland. Everybody quiet this evening. I'm reading a eulogy. Dropped an album called Kamikaze. So that means he killed him. Already fucked one rapper's girl this week. Don't make me call Kim. I'm sick of them sweatsuits and them corny hats. Let's talk about it. I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad. Let's talk about it. Or of a single dad's from the Midwest. We can talk about it. Or we can get gully. I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it.
I like that ending when he takes a shovel again, because that's Eminem's cleaning out my closet shovel, and he just whacks the camera with it and we go to black. And then obviously he takes shots at G-Eazy and Halsey, because he's saying that he got with G-Eazy's girl, right? Okay, so there's that little bit, and G-Eazy fired back at him. They had a little bit of back and forth, so he took it as an opportunity to diss another rapper, but he's also dissing M because we know Kim is M's ex-wife, and they've had so much that they've been through. So he's saying, you know, don't make me call up Kim. Okay. Now listen, overall, right, like I pointed out, this wasn't the most technically advanced of raps in terms of the internal schemes, in terms of the flow switches. But where he made up for that was with the overall swagger, with the style of the video. And I think one of the things is that not many people have really just come out and openly diss M like this and really swung at him. Like, I remember watching this video and going, oh, M's gonna have to respond to this. Because if it wasn't good, if it didn't hit, if it didn't have some bites in it, Eminem could have just ignored it like he did with Nick Cannon, which we saw was a whack diss track. No, this is a solid diss track, man. This is like, roll your sleeves up, get to work, let me get in the booth, and let me just speak my shit. It's very relatable. It's definitely got that relatability. But to swing at a king, man, it's got that shock value. It's like, wow, oh, he's talking about M. Oh, he said that about M? He did. No, he didn't. Really opens your eyes to it, because it takes balls. It takes balls, man. It takes a certain amount of confidence and swagger and belief in yourself to go after a king, to try to be a king killer, because you know the backlash that you're going to get. You know what's coming the second that you release this, and you were getting in the ring with the Titan. So mad props to MGK for that. I thought it was a very solid diss. Honestly, MGK, you were Knox Hill certified. But we're here to break down both. We've had this discussion about who you guys think won the battle. And then I said, you know, if you want me to react to this, I'm going to break them both down. So I got about 5 minutes on my camera before it dies, which means we can hook up Eminem's response, and we'll keep going. We'll keep going. Let's go.
You sound like a bitch, bitch.
Shut the fuck up.
Your fans become your haters.
You done?
You sound like a bitch, bitch. Because MGK just did that and tried to flip it on him, talking about call up Trick Trick, flipping his lines. And this is a very clever intro by M, because he's basically just trolling MGK now. And one great thing about this diss track is that he just takes each and every one of MGK's lines and responds to it, whether it's on this intro, whether it's throughout the verses, and he just flips them in his own Eminem type of way.
Right.
You know, weird beard disses. He's making fun of what he thought were some of his weaker punches. Because some of his stronger punches he addresses and he flips back. But some of the weaker ones he put here in this intro, like trolling him, like, that's the best you got? That's the best that you can come with?
Your fans become your haters.
You done?
Beard's weird.
All right.
Yelling at the mic. Weird, weird.
You're doing this
yelling
once.
Beard's weird. Why you yelling at the mic?
Rihanna just hit me on a text. Last night I left hickeys on her neck. Wait, you just dissed me? I'm perplexed.
Rihanna just hit me on a text. Last night I left hickeys on her neck. You just dissed me? I'm perplexed. Already, the multi-syllable rhyme schemes packed not even at the end lines, within lines. I mean, come on. Come on. The way that he writes, man. The way that his mind thinks. The things that he can connect and rhyme. And then he's still responding to MGK. Saying, look, man. You tried to troll me. Saying that I'm too scared to ask Rihanna for a number. Well, she just hit me on a text. I was just with her last night leaving hickey. So you can guess what that means. And what comes from that.
A text. Last night I left hickeys on her neck. Wait. You just dissed me, I'm perplexed. Insult me in a line, compliment me on the next. Damn, I'm really sorry you want me to have a heart attack. Was watching 8 Mile on my Nauta track. Realized I...
Oh, man. He's got that humor, too. I'm really sorry you want me to have a heart attack. Like, damn. Oh, man. It's the end of the world. What a shame. Because I was actually watching my movie, 8 Mile, that I was in, that I starred in and won all these awards for and had all these accolades for on my super, super expensive treadmill. Because, yeah. There's nothing wrong with exercising, is there? I like the way he flips some of this stuff. And one of the biggest flips and one of the biggest weaknesses that I would have seen from M's perspective, and I'm glad he did it, was that MGK admitted that M is one of his idols. And MGK does have lines where he compliments M. Like, we get it. You're top 10. You're one of the best. You're one of the greatest alive. Blah, blah, blah. Fucking dweeb. Like, how can you compliment someone and then insult them? Because it's a diss. Just diss them. Just keep dissing them. Don't throw them compliments. Don't give them any more ammunition than they already have. Especially when you're going up against one of the GOATs. I mean, MGK should not have done that. I don't know why he did that. But anyways, M just took it and just flipped it right there. Opening lines. That's it. Addressed. On to the next.
I got to call you back. Here's that autograph for your daughter. I wrote it on a starter cap.
So now I wrote it on a starter cap. Because that is from Stan, right? See how MGK took some of M's favorite lines and used it on him? Now M is taking some of his favorite lines, like from Stan, and he's flipping it back onto MGK. Oh, I love the mirroring there.
I got to call you back. Here's that autograph for your daughter. I wrote it on a starter cap.
Stan, son, listen, man, dad isn't mad, but how you gonna name yourself after a damn gun and have a man bun? Giant smoke eyes.
I like those lines, but yeah, if we're being like super objective here, it's not like that's a terrible diss, but you know, MGK was getting petty. So M's like, all right, you want to get petty? You want to make fun of me for how I look? Well, you're named after a damn gun, bragging about it, remember? MGK with his lines saying that he's named after this. And M goes, well, that's funny because you have a man bun. That's super scary. I should be afraid right now. Sorry, guys. Camera died. But we're back. I think I was talking about M's flow right there. So, you know, when he's like, listen, Stan, man, son, how you gonna name yourself after a damn gun and have a man bun? Just love those pauses and just that flow, man. And I've said this before. Sometimes it's not about, you know, what you say is what you don't say, where you choose to pause and let things marinate and chop up the flow and switch it up. And already M's had like 3 different flow switches and we're just getting started. We're just getting cooking with this.
Put undeniable supply and smoke and have a man bun. Giant smoke eyes open undeniable.
And the pitcher trolls him. The pitcher trolls him because there's MGK with his man bun, and M's got him in the scope. Headshot, the kill shot.
Apple supplying smoke, got the fire stoke. Say you got me in a scope, but you grazed me. I say one called it in a scope, and you Swayze.
Say you got me in a scope, but he's playing off of Interscope. Again, all M does, and this is what's great about this whole diss, is that he just takes each and every one of MGK's lines, he works through them, and he flips it back on him. You know, you're accusing me of calling Interscope, of blackballing you? No. All it takes is for me to make one call to Interscope, and you really will be Swayze. You'll be Ghost, like Patrick Swayze from the movie Ghost. I will ghost you in a heartbeat if you really want to call me on that, because I didn't do that. That's not true. You see how M is flipping this on him, but also in the scope, like he's got you in the scope with this kill shot.
Say you got me in a scope, but you grazed me. I say one called it in a scope, and you Swayze. Your reply got...
Sorry, say you got me in the scope, right? Got me in the scope, like you're a gunner. You're the gunner. You just grazed me. It's nothing. It's nothing to me.
Crowd yelling, woo, so before you die, let's see who can out-petty who with your corny lines.
Slim your old
Al Kelly, ooh, but I'm 45, and I'm still outselling you. By 29,
But I'm 45 and I'm still outselling you. What a great way to take all the age remarks by MGK and all the disses on him for how old he is, like he can't stand up. And he's like, yeah, okay, make fun of me for being old, but I'm still more successful than you at this age. And when I was your age, I was still more successful with you. So what are we really talking about here? Negates another point that he makes.
Three albums that it blew. Now let's talk about some. And I'm still outselling you. By 29, I had three albums that it blew. Now let's talk about something I don't really do. Going with someone.
Three albums that it blew. The Marshall Mathers LP. The Eminem Show. And the Slim Shady LP.
All this mouth stealing food, but you're a fucking molehill. Now I'm gonna make a mountain out of you. Ho chill, like
I do like that line. You're a molehill. You're just this. But I'm gonna turn you into a mountain. I'm gonna give you the fame that you want. I'm gonna give you what you want. See, I'm not here to take, you know, food out of your daughter's mouth. So me doing this is actually going to put more food in your daughter's mouth. He's even acknowledging that because he's so big now. The second that he mentions you and responds, it's going to get you so much attention. And MGK had that album ready to go, didn't he? He was smart, man. He released that album soon after this. Released Binge, like, yep, I'm going to capitalize on this attention.
But you're a fucking molehill. Now I'm going to make a mountain out of you. Ho chill, acting like you put the chrome barrel to my bone marrow. Gonna beat you, ain't a bow and arrow. Say you run up on me like a phone bill. Spraying lead, playing dead, that's the only time you hold still. Are you eating?
Playing dead, that's the only time you hold still. But still, like the only time that you got a gun. Like, you say that you're gonna shoot me. You only graze me. You're a bow and arrow. Acting like you're gonna put the chrome barrel to my bone marrow. You're just a bow and arrow. You don't have any ammunition. You're thinking that you're firing shots, but you're not really firing shots this way. It's a clever way to take his name, flip it back on him, since MGK took his name and put it on him.
On me like a phone bill, spraying lead, playing dead. That's the only time you hold still.
Are you eating cereal or oatmeal? What the fuck's in the bowl, milk, Wheaties or Cheerios? Because I'm taking a shit in them, Kelly. I need reading material. Dictionary. Yo, Slim, your last four.
Now he addresses the dictionary, nonsense. You know, you're a fucking dweeb. All you do is sit there and read the dictionary. And I like that. He's like, I'm taking a shit in it. Like, you're doing that for breakfast? This is what I'm doing for my breakfast. Having my shit, just taking a shit on everything that you're saying and what you're doing right now. And I asked that same question, didn't I? Like, what is in that bowl? What is it? We all want to know. MGK, for some reason you're watching this, tell me.
Album suck. Go back to recovery. Oh, shoot.
Dictionary.
Yo, Slim, your last four albums suck. Go back to recovery. Oh, shoot, that was three albums ago.
Also, just to play on that and explain it more thoroughly, you know, like sitting on the john, sitting on the toilet, you know, some people, they like to read. They like to enjoy that time. So he's saying, you know, I'm sitting on the john and I'm just sat here reading the dictionary while I'm dissing you. Isn't it great?
Yo, Slim, your last four albums suck. Go back to recovery. Oh, shoot, that was three albums ago. What do you know? Oops. Know your facts before you come at me, little goof. Luxury, oh, you broke.
Smart. I told you he was going to do that, didn't I? I told you he was going to do that. Because MGK is like, your last four albums sucked. Go back to recovery. Oh, shoot, that was three albums ago. You see how he mimicked his line? Had a little humor in there, a little bit of entertainment value, but he's flipping what he's saying, and he's pointing out that weakness.
Bitch, yeah, clever. I had enough money in 02 to burn it in front of you, ho. Younger me, no, you'd have whacked me. It's funny, but so true. I'd rather be 80.
I don't wanna, why didn't I stop it too soon?
To burn it in front of you, ho. Younger me, no, you done whack me.
It's funny, but so true. I'd rather be 80-year-old me than 20-year-old you.
That's it. That says it. I was going to address it earlier, but that last line is probably the best punch of that whole scheme right there. I'd rather be 80-year-old me than 20-year-old you, because MGK just sat there saying like, oh, you know, he a younger me, except I'm better looking, and your fans are now supporting me from all this. And M's like, no, you'll never be me. I'd rather be even older than I am, since you want to talk age. I'd rather be an old man than a young you, and I'll probably still be doing better and doing more. As, again, taking what he's saying, turning it on its head, flipping it, and throwing it back at him while still dissing him. You have to appreciate the art that it takes to do that and the clever mind that goes into it.
Till I'm hitting old age, still can fill a whole page with a 10-year-old's rage.
Till I'm hitting old age, still can fill your... Oh, my brain's getting tired. Come on. Till I'm hitting old age, still can fill a whole page with a 10-year-old's rage. What I wanted to point out there was the internal schemes. You hear those, the ill, old page. And then also the pauses and the breathing in between. Another nice flow switch from M. Just the technicals on this man are crazy.
Fans, then you
crazy. I think I'm going crazy too. I've been doing this too long now.
In your own city, little kitty, go play. Feel like I'm...
Ah, that's a good one.
Page with a 10-year-old's rage. Got more fans than you in your own city, little kitty, go play. Feel like I'm babysitting Lil Tay. Ah. Got the ditty okay.
Lil Tay, man. Oh my God. So he's... Did he diss? I can't remember if he dissed or not. But anyways, what I like is that MGK is talking about, you know, repping Cleveland and all this, and you're scared to go outside. And M's like, yeah, but I got more fans than you in your own city. Like, that's a great diss right there, because how many rappers rep their city and rep where they're from? And M's like, your city likes me more.
You spent your whole day shooting a video just to fucking dig your own grave. Got you at your own wake. I'm the Philly goat. You ain't never made a...
Ah, we missed something there. Hang on.
Little kitty, go play. Feel like I'm babysitting Lil Tay. Got the ditty okay, so you spent your whole day shooting a video just to fucking dig your own grave. Got you at your own wake. I'm the Philly goat. You ain't never made a list. Next to no Biggie, no Jay. Next to Taylor Swift and that Iggy Home. You about to really blow, Kelly.
You about to really blow. And then he says, you know, like Taylor Swift, like Iggy. Like, he's getting a little dirty with it. You know, like, you're really going to blow with the double entendre, you're going to blow up too. And he's like, I get compared with goats. This is your list. This is your future list that you're going to be put next to. And there's a very important line there. You got the ditty okay. Like, your boss, you called your boss asking if you could do this diss, if you could come out and diss me. You want to talk about calling people up to see if you can do things or to see what's right. You called your boss and got that okay to shoot this music video all day to come after me. And M remembers that because he fires a little shot at Diddy at the end. And this is the setup for it. This is why he's doing it, because he's acknowledging, I know who's pulling the strings behind the scenes here.
Your name next to time, next to Benzino time. Motherfucker like the last motherfucker saying alien vein, alien brain. Satanist, yeah. My biggest flops are your greatest hits. The games.
So MGK dissing M for his albums and for not being the same. M is saying that, okay, you want to put that on me? Well, my flops and my shit that you say isn't good is still better than your best shit. That's still your greatest hits. It would make that list. Me on a bad day is way better than you on your best day. Like that flip. And then he's saying about Ja and Benzino, because they mentioned Haley, and look where they are now. I mean, Ja Rule is still in Shaq's toilet somewhere. So that's where he is. But, you know, he ends careers, M. He's ended careers for people going after him. Not many rappers can say that. Not many rappers can claim that.
Not again, and ain't nothing changed but the lock. So before I slay this bitch, I'm gonna give Jada kiss.
Nah.
Gotta wake up.
Jada kiss, part of the locks. Love playing on the locks before you change the locks to the game, right? But also locks. Jada kiss the rapper, but also give Jade a kiss. Haley Jade. I'ma give Haley a kiss. Jada kiss. I mean, even when he's dissing you, he's still throwing homophones in there and doubles and triples. The man is on another planet. Alien brain.
Nothing changed but the lock, so before I slay this bitch, I'm gonna give Jada a kiss. Gotta wake up Labor Day to this. Being rich shamed by some prick using my name for clickbait in a state of bliss. Nah. Cause I said his goddamn name, now I gotta cock back aim. Yeah, bitch, pop champagne to this.
One of the most famous lines, and it just hits you like it's not a crazy punchline, but gotta wake up Labor Day to this. That's become a meme. That's become so popular. Like, sometimes you don't know what's going to stick with people. I mean, that stuck with me when I first heard it too. Damn, got to wake up Labor Day and deal with this shit now? All right. If I got to deal with this, come on. Let's go.
The moment. Now I got a cock back aim. Yeah, bitch, pop champagne to this. It's your moment. This is it.
And that pop champagne. MGK, it was on Twitter, wasn't it? Was it Kamikaze? What was it? But anyways, MGK was sat there popping champagne to Eminem, right? So Eminem is now taking that, and he's flipping that. See, every line is packed with something, man. M is taking what MGK has done or said or implies and flipping it back on him. Pop champagne, because this is it for you. This is the mountain, my friend. This is the peak. It's only downhill from here.
Biggest you're gonna get, so enjoy it. Had to give you a career to destroy it. Lethal injection, go to sleep 6 feet deep.
Oh, had to give you a career to destroy it. MGK's lines about wanting to be the old you so bad you stand yourself, his best line. This one for me, M's best line. Love that punch.
Give you a beat for the effort, but if I was 3'11", you'd look up to me, and for the record, you would suck a dick to fucking be me for a second.
Nah.
Lick a ball sack to get on my channel. Give your life to be a solidified. This motherfucking shit is like Rambo when he's out of bullets, so what good is a fucking machine gun when it's out of ammo? Nah. Had enough of this tatted up mumble rapper. How the fuck?
To be me? You know, you want to make all these comparisons? Like, you're a younger, better me? No. The things that you would do to actually be me, to do my numbers, to have my level of success, if you really want to take that and talk about it. Another flip. And then he's saying, you know, you say you're a machine gun. What good is that when the bullets that you're firing aren't even hitting me? You're not even landing your punches.
So what good is a fucking machine gun when it's out of ammo? Had enough of this tatted up mumble rapper. How the fuck can him and I battle? He'll have to fuck him in my flannel. Yeah. I'll give him my sandals, cause he knows long as I'm shady, he's gonna have to live in my shadow. Exhausting, letting off.
Oh my god. The doubles, man. The doubles are what get you. As long as I'm shady, Slim Shady. But also, I'm shady. When you're shady, you're casting a lot of shade, right? He's gonna have to live in my shadow, cause he wants to be shady so bad. He's going to have to wear his flannel in order to get with Kim. Because him saying that he's like Shady isn't good enough. He's literally going to have to dress like him. He's going to have to be exactly like him. But he will still always be in his shadow.
My sandals, because he knows long as I'm Shady, he's going to have to live in my shadow. Exhausting, letting off on my offspring. Like a gun barrel, bitch, get off me.
Another flow switch. Exhausting, letting off on my offspring. Here he changes his cadence and he goes up. Such great changes in delivery, cadence, flow, style. I mean, he's just got it all, man. And apparently he wrote this in like 13 minutes. It's crazy. But he's saying, you know, I inspired you. I'm letting off my offspring. You're one of my kids. You're one of the people that I inspired with hip-hop and what I've done. Really? I gotta do this now? I gotta come after you, son? Sort you out?
Surround it like a sombrero. We can all see. Off on my offspring. Lick a gun barrel. Bitch, get off me. You dance around it like a...
Lick a gun barrel. He's saying commit suicide there.
Exhausting, letting off on my offspring. Like a gun barrel, bitch, get off me. You dance around it like a...
And did you hear there's an ad-lib where he goes... Ch-ch-ch-ch. It's just very slight in the mix. He's got some funny ad-libs that he throws in too. You know, making fun of you for being a machine gunner. Saying that you got me in the scope. Go and lick a gun barrel. Ch-ch.
Exhausting, letting off on my offspring. Like a gun barrel, bitch, get off me. You dance around it like a sombrero. We can all see you're fucking salty, cause young Gerald's balls deep inside a Halsey.
Another nice internal scream. Internal scheme. Words are gonna become more and more difficult the longer I have to break this down, cause my brain is getting fried. Young Gerald is G-Eazy. So he's back with Halsey, and you're bragging about this, and yet you couldn't keep her because she's going back to G-Eazy now. So we all know that you're salty. Dance around it like a sombrero. You don't want to actually address the topic at hand.
Your red sweater, your black leather. You dress better, I rap better. That a death threater, a love letter. Little white toothpick.
Great flips. Great flips again. Again, all this is just flipping what he's saying and just firing back and showing, okay, I can take anything you say and flip it back on you. You want to talk about that you have better fashion sense than me? You take better selfies than me? All right, I don't give a shit. I rap better. That's what matters. Let's make it about rap. And you notice there's no hooks on this. There's no bridges. There's nothing like that. It's just him rapping, coming at him for 4 minutes straight.
Things is over a pick. I just don't like you, prick. Thanks for dissing me. Now I had an excuse on the mic to write, not a light. But really, I don't care who's on the right. But you're losing the fight you pick.
Mm. You're losing the fight that you picked. Thanks for dissing me, because I had an excuse to write, not a like. And here's the thing, right? And here's the difference in the narrative. And MGK saying this is all over a tweet, and what he said about Haley, and he made that about his rap devil. And Eminem is saying through this response, through Killshot, no, 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 no. You're missing something. You're missing where you diss me. You fired at me first. You went on that Tech N9ne song and fired some blims at me. And then it hit my radar and I responded. And then after I responded, you came out and dropped a whole video against me and a whole song against me, making it look like, oh, this came out of nowhere. No, 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 no. You stirred the pot first. You wanted this, and now I'm coming to finish it.
Who else wanted Kells? Attempt fails. Button L's. Fucking nails. In these coffins, they're soft as cottonelle. Kill shot.
Cottonelle. You know, toilet paper is saying that they're soft, right? They're taking L's. They're taking L's. Who else wanted? Little shot of Joe Budden there, too.
I will not fail. I'm with the doc still. But this idiot's boss pops pills and tells him he's got skills. But Kells a day.
I'm with the doc still. Again, taking what MGK has said, you know, about Dre producing M. And M's like, okay, I'm with the doc still. And? What's your point? I got a boss who has helped me. And I admit that. I'm going to own it and wear it like armor. Because that's why I'm so damn good with my sound. Like, I'm talented. I got talented people around me. Let's look at you and the people that you're surrounded by. Your boss is over here being all drugged up, popping pills, telling you that you've got skills. And now he's going to swing back at Diddy.
Fail, I'm with the doc still, but this idiot's boss pops pills and tells him he's got skills. But Kells, the day you put out a hits, the day Diddy admits that he put the hit out, think I pop kill, ah. I'm sick of you being whack and still using that motherfucking auto-tune, so let's talk about it. Talk about it.
Man, that really hits hard too. I mean, there's been speculation, there's been conspiracies. Biggie, East Coast, NYC, Puffy close with Biggie. Pac, West Coast. West to East rivalry, and speculation that Diddy is the one who put out the hit that killed Pac. And M just comes out and says it because, again, Diddy had to give MGK the okay for this. So Diddy could have said no. Diddy could have shut this down, but he didn't. So M's not forgetting that, and M's taking advantage of the opportunity to take some shots back at Diddy, take shots at his boss. Well, you talked about Dre. You want to talk about Dre. You want to talk about Jimmy. You want to talk about my people. Let's talk about your people, MGK.
Ah, I'm sick of you being whack and still using that motherfucking auto-tune, so let's talk about it.
Talk about it.
I'm sick of your mumble rap mouth.
The auto-tune in the hook, I pointed that out too.
Whack and still using that motherfucking auto-tune, so let's talk about it.
Talk about it.
I'm sick of your mumble rap mouth, need to get the cock about it before we can even talk about it.
Talk about it.
I'm sick of your blonde hair and earrings, just cause you look in the mirror and think.
Need to get the cock out of your mouth, that's why you're a mumble rapper, he's dissing mumble rappers. We know MGK is not a mumble rapper, but the reason he's mumbling is because he's got that in his mouth.
Before we can even talk about it.
Talk about it.
I'm sick of your blonde hair and earrings, just cause you look in the mirror and think that you're Marshall Mathers.
Marshall Mathers.
Don't mean you are and you're not about it, so just leave my dick in your mouth and keep my daughter out of you. You fucking. Oh. And I'm just playing, Diddy. You know I love you.
What was it? It was on You Don't Wanna Fuck With Shady. Why? Cause Shady will fucking kill you. I'm just playing, ladies. You know I love you. He likes to do that, you know? Like, he says just this wild, dark shit. And then he's like, I'm just playing. You know I love you. It's him trolling. It's him being Slim Shady. And then the way that he ended it there, you know? You keep talking about me and want to diss me, yet you're the one who's got the blonde hair like me, the earrings like me. You're the one who says that you're the next me. So you're so obsessed with me. How about you stop talking about my daughter and get my own dick up out of your mouth for what you're doing. It's nice, man. It's nice. I mean, again, one of the arguments that I saw and the things that people said was that MGK had harder punches. I mean, MGK did have some hard punches, to be fair, and we pointed those out. But if you look at the overall balance, he had some hard punches and then he had some punches that just, I don't know, they didn't make sense. They were either super generic or, I don't know, very low brow. They didn't do it for me. But he did have some nice swings, and he had some great swagger. And we talked about that. The reason for the swagger helps with the delivery. It makes you think that the punchline hits harder than it actually is when you peel it back and you look at it. But what M did really well, and this is an advantage to going second in a diss battle, is that you can take everything that someone says and you have the opportunity to take it and flip it. And that's exactly what he did. That's textbook dissing right there. He takes what he says, flips it, turns it back on him, and makes it an insult at himself. And for that reason, M literally went through the list and addressed, I'm pretty sure he addressed every single line that MGK threw at him, and he flipped it back on him. For that reason alone, you have to give the W to Eminem. If you want to step back and look at it objectively, you want to look at the metrics, you want to look at the internal rhyme schemes, the flow switches, the mastery on the mic with the wordplay, that goes to M. But music is subjective. And like I said, this very blue-collar mentality is very, very relatable from MGK. Like, he just, you know, he seems like one of those dudes that's just super down to earth, and he just tells it like it is, and he keeps it 100, and he's just a grinder, and you have to respect that. So because of that relatability and the way that he carried himself and the charisma that he had, I could see people supporting MGK from this. I could see people getting behind MGK. And for MGK fans out there watching this who are probably going to come at me and say that I'm a little biased, yes, I am an Eminem fan. Of course I'm an Eminem fan. Okay, white kid, all black community. Eminem paved the path for me, just like he did for MGK. We both grew up looking up to Eminem. I'm not going to deny that, but I'm also an MGK fan. And if you look at this channel, there's been a number of MGK songs that I have reacted to, and I will continue to react to both Eminem and MGK. I thought that this diss track battle between the two was actually good for hip hop because it didn't end in violence, right? It didn't end with someone in a coffin. It was one track and one track back and forth. It was good for the culture. It got people talking. It got a buzz about it. Since then, MGK has taken off. He hasn't stopped. He's put out yet another album. He's experimenting, trying different genres. He's pushing himself. Eminem dropping music to be murdered by. Eminem is pushing himself too. So it's turned out really good for the culture and good for hip hop. So Eminem and MGK, you know what? Both of you are Knox Hill certified. So hope you guys liked today's video. I know that my voice is starting to go, man. It's getting hoarse. This has been a crazy long video. I'm not going to do a long outro. I just want to say that if you are still here at the end of this video, do me a favor and subscribe. Subscribe, notifications on. Stick around. Support the team because you obviously like what I'm doing. Thanks as always, guys. This is your reminder to stay safe, to stay positive. It's Knox Hill, and I'll catch you in the next video. I'm out.